Tina and eat dinner at the same time. So one of the pastors sitting at the table with us offered to take her daughter so that the mother pastor could feed herself more easily. And so sure enough, she handed off Christina to the pastor next to her, who was delighted to have this little girl in her arms. But it only lasted about 30 seconds. And then Christina was pushing away, the arms were flailing, and the sounds were coming. And sure enough, she had to go back to her mother's arms. And in an instant, she settled right back in and the comfort of the mother's arms. So that the mother had to struggle with Christina and her food as best she could. And it reminded me of what it says at the end of Isaiah chapter 66. Verse 13, the prophet said, as a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you. You shall be comforted, O Jerusalem, says the Lord. Well, happy Mother's Day to all of our mothers out there. Thanks for all that you do and have done. And for those of us who are not mothers, we can certainly appreciate the love of a mother and the gift it is in our lives. And we all can appreciate it. The gift of knowing God who comes to us and comforts us as loving parents. Let's turn our hearts and minds to this never-ending loving God.
Thank you.
rejoice with all creation around God's throne. The light of the risen Christ puts to flight all evil deeds, washes away sin, restores innocence to the fallen, casts out hate, brings peace, and upholds earthly pride. Jesus Christ loves you and frees you from your sins by his blood. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Together let us pray.
Almighty God, we pray for compassion and humility in our hearts. Let us be kind, gentle, generous, loving, giving, and forgiving, wherever we may go. Our hearts may be fixed for true joy is found. Your Son, Jesus.
first reading for the seventh Sunday of Easter is found in Colossians, third chapter, verses 12 and 17. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. Above all, clothe yourself with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which you call in one mind, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom. And with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading is found in the 22nd chapter of Revelation. See, I'm coming soon. My reward is with me to repay according to everyone's work. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes so that they will have the right to the tree of life and may enter the city by the gates. It is I, Jesus, who sent my angel to you with this testimony for the churches. I am the root and the descendant of David, the bright morning star. The Spirit and the Bride say, come. And let everyone who hears say, come. Let everyone who is thirsty come. But anyone who wishes to take the water of life as a gift. The one who testifies to these things says, surely I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with all the saints. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He went to him and bandaged his wounds, having poured oil and wine on them. Then he put him on his own animal, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 denarii, gave them to the innkeeper, and said, "Take care of him. And when I come back, I will repay you whatever more you spend." Which of these 3 do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of the robbers? He said, "The one who showed him mercy." Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
I invite the congregation to stay standing, and we're going to sing our hymn of the day, which will actually be our final hymn, number 656. So we'll sing the hymn of the day, 656.
Gospel, we encounter the parable
the answer, love God and love your neighbor, but the lawyer pushes him and says, well, who is my neighbor? What Jesus teaches us seems very interesting because I would imagine most of you know who your neighbor is. I think about my neighbor growing up. Her name was Celine, not Dion, but Celine Flores, and she taught me about running and about mowing the lawn with a lawnmower that doesn't have a motor, and of course was good for a cup of sugar if we ever needed it. But Jesus doesn't talk about that kind of neighbor. We all know those kinds of neighbors, friends and family. What Jesus talks about is even inclusive of our enemies. The Samaritan would have been an enemy of the Jew who would have been hurt on the side of the road. And so we get this example of these two comparisons of what it means to be our neighbor. And what Jesus tells us is that we are simply called to love without judgment. Love without boundaries. All Jesus desires is for us to love God in this way and to love one another. Today we are celebrating our ministry as a Stephen Ministry congregation, one of the many ways that we care for others. Caring not necessarily for enemies, but this idea of caring no matter what. Caring without judgment, without limits. And it's something that is part of our identity here at Calvary, one of the many ways that we give glory to God and share Christ's love. So I want to invite forward now one of our Stephen ministers, Jim Hutchison, who's going to talk with you a bit about his experiences as a Stephen minister. Let's welcome Jim to our pulpit.
People say, oh, doesn't it take a lot of commitment? Well, At first, it does. Stephen ministry requires that you go through 50 hours of training over roughly a four-month period. We do role-playing. We work on active, reflective listening. We become comfortable doing prayer. And we also learn about community resources and support that would be available to our care receiver. One of the hardest things for us guys is that we tend to be problem solvers. We tend to be fixers. We want to fix things. But that's not the role of a Stephen minister. The role of a Stephen minister is to journey with our care receiver, to find that road and to go along that road with our care receiver, to be what God needs us to be for that care receiver. But after that training, it becomes more like spending an hour or so a week with a friend, listening, caring, sharing, praying. And can't we all do that? And then after that, a couple of evenings a month, we meet with the other Stephen ministers to learn about how we can become more effective care receivers. There's a Stephen ministry compass. And it says it has 4 points. The 4 points are compassionate, full of faith, skilled, and trustworthy. And isn't that what we all want in a friend? And shouldn't we be that as friends and servants of Christ? Jesus said, "Feed my sheep, tend my lambs." And we feel that Stephen ministry is a very powerful way to answer that call. So today, on Stephen Ministry Sunday, I would urge all of you to prayerfully consider finding out more about becoming a Stephen minister and becoming more compassionate, full of faith, skilled, and trustworthy. And to become a friend to someone and to share Christ's love with him or her. So I would ask you all, consider in your hearts, is this something that we can do to share, to be a friend, to be compassionate, to share God's love? I know in my case, it has richly blessed my life every day, to feel that I am reaching out, serving God in a way that I may not always feel comfortable doing, but knowing that I am being what God needs me to be for my care receiver. I thank you all, and I wish you the best today. God bless you all.
It's been almost exactly 10 years since my wife Rivers and I found the job the first time, which led to a whole bunch of things. Phil's situation has gone from oops to oh my God to holy. And it's still there. I mean, she still can't walk from the original surgery. She's wheelchair bound, doesn't get out very much. He's on dialysis now because her kidneys failed. And I've been the guy who's been there all that time. And I was just putting so much pressure on myself. And so finally, one of the guys, a good buddy, called me home and he said, "We are going to get you a Stephen minister." He knew all that story. He said, "We're going to get you a Stephen minister." And I said, "Well, it's time. It's time." My Stephen minister is just a little bit older than I. And sometimes when we're together, I have to say, even to him, you know, we're just like two old friends sitting around drinking coffee on a Wednesday morning. It's just so easy to be with him. He's just so tuned in to what that he knows the right questions. He never suggests anything. He's not there to tell me what to do. He's there to get me to talk to myself until I discover what is necessary. And I can tell him anything. He listens to anything. He listens to good stuff. He listens to bad stuff. He's also very happy about the successes that I've had along the way. I can't wait to tell him about something. So it's been a lot of pressure. But my Stephen minister has just walked me through it, talked me through it, questioned me through it, and I'm surviving very nicely. I'm grateful to Trinity for caring enough, the people that were caring enough to literally put a Stephen minister in my back pocket, because I wouldn't be where I am today if it weren't for that. So I give thanks every day. In fact, my connection with the church now is I don't go to worship to take, I go to give. I have gotten so much from the church, so much through my stable minister, that I go to give it all back, or give it back as much of it as I possibly can every Sunday morning. This relationship with the Stephen minister is about the view of God and getting you through the next period. I'm very proud to say I have a Stephen minister. If you're under anything like the pressure that I was under then, would you like to be where I am now? You can get there if you have a Stephen minister. But you can't have the one that I have.
One of the leadership team who's coordinating our community service today will reach out to you and have a
conversation about the ways that, that you can plug yourself in that fits best for you and for the ministry we're accomplishing that day. I do want to highlight, too, that Pastor Grusin and Carolyn Ambler were attending Synod Assembly the last couple of days. This is an annual gathering of congregations around our Synod that is sort of a business meeting. If you would like more information about that, we do invite you to ask him about it, what a Synod Assembly is, and all the wonderful things that we are doing as a larger church, as a Synod and a nation together. Let us now continue to worship God with our offering.
Thank you.
love and the work of our lives. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Declare your righteousness through the blossoming of creation. By the winds blowing and birds singing, inspire us to join in the hymn of all creation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Be the source of all strength and peace for people who are in prison. Renew them with the overwhelming power of your salvation, and give them release from their spirits. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Reveal yourself to those who feel isolated because of illness, grief, sadness, or the prejudice of others, especially.
We pray for healing for Bob Clark, Sharon Detter, Peach Hiltvital, Carl Garrison, Susie Hauser, Dave Jackson, Jane Lee, Pastor Beth Locker, Melissa Norholm, Rex Schutte, John Stambulian, Jaron Zerlo, as well as the homebound saints in need. And we pray for your peace and comfort to surround all who are mourning the loss of loved ones, especially for the families and friends of George Dillon and Myrtle Lynn Blatt. And we pray for those serving in the military, especially David Annan, Andy Clark, Wesley Clark, Michael Dugan, Alexis Cole Harris, Michael Maselli, Latrell Murphy, Evan Scholl, Christopher Teal, Trevor Teal, and James Leica. And we pray for all missionaries and Peace Corps volunteers, especially Miles Nussbaum.
Comfort and welcome them into your spirit-filled community. Hear us, O God. Bless those who serve in a mothering role for others. Send your spirit to those who mourn, who have not known their mothers, or who long to be a mother. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Let us pause for a moment of silent prayer.
We deliver all this into your care, O God, trusting in the work of your Holy Spirit to bring all things into the risen life of Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray together as Jesus has taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Among you and remain with you always.